healthcare provider can use for diagnosing them by looking at the affected skin and asking questions about their symptoms. He or she may also take a small skin scraping to be examined by under microscope or sent to a laboratory for fungal culture. Physical examination. A thorough history and physical examination of it's often sufficient to diagnose the tinea. The classic lesion is an erythematous raised skin leading with central clearing. Multiple lesions may be present. The severity of infection can range from mild scaly lesions to extensive lesions. Characteristics of superimposed bacterial infections. Microscopy. Potassium hydroxide stain, a commonly used method for diagnosing tinea because it is inexpensive, easy to perform and high sensitivity. Scraping from lesions are placed in a drop of KOH and examined under a microscope for the presence of fungal hyphae. Ultraviolet light, wounds lamp. Normally, ultraviolet light is not useful in diagnosis of tinea. With the expectation of two species, Microsporum camis and Odonyl, although both species fluorescently blue-green under a wounds lamp, both species are uncommon causes of tinea infections. Culture. Fungal infection can be performed as a confirmatory test. If a result from a KO stain or inconclusive, air or scrapping extracted from affected areas are placed on subornax medium. Fungal medium is more specific than KO stain, but it can take up 2 or 3 weeks to become positive. Treatment. Tinea pedis. Arthritis foot can usually be treated with over-the-counter topical antifungal products. Terbinafine appears to be more effective, but other agents can also be used. Chronic or expensive tinea pedis may require treatment with oral antifungal agents such as terbinafine, itraconazole, fluconazole. In addition, chronic tinea pedis may require adjunctive therapy such as foot powder or talcum powder to prevent skin maceration. Tinea capitis usually needs to be treated with precaution antifungal medication taken by mouth for 1 to 3 months. Treatment with systemic antifungal medicine is required as topical antifungal products are ineffective for the treatment of tinea capitis. Many experts consider grisophyllin to be given the drug of choice. Terbinafine is also FDA approved for the treatment of tinea capitis in patients 4 years of age and older. Tinea corpus. Tinea corpus and tinea cruris can usually be treated with over-the-counter antifungal products to be applied twice a day for 10 to 14 days. Patients who have tinea cruris should be advised to keep the groin area clean and dry and not to wear cotton underwear. To treat the itch, it often helps to apply a wet, cool wash cloth to the area for 20 to 30 minutes. You may need to apply cool compress 2 to 6 times a day. When washing the infected area or applying a cool compress, be sure to use a clean wash cloth every time and use it only on the job itch. Before using the wash cloth again, you will want to wash it in hot sudsy water to kill the fungus. Ringworm can serve on objects for a long time. Steroid creams can make ringworm worse. Do not use steroid creams to treat rashes that may ringworm. People who have ringworm do not always know what's causing their rash. For the reason, people sometimes apply over-the-counter creams or ointments containing medications called corticosteroids to their rash. Steroid creams can be helpful for skin problems and can even temporarily reduce ringworm symptoms like itching and redness, but they do not kill fungus that cause ringworm. Steroid creams can also make ringworm worse. They weaken the skin defenses. In rare disease, steroid creams allow the fungus that cause ringworm to invade deeper into the skin and cause a serious condition. Strong steroid creams can also permanently thinning of skin stretch marks and white marks from the loss of skin pigment. Complications. A fungal infection rarely spreads below the surface of the skin to cause serious illness, but people with weak immune system such as those with HIV and AIDS may find it difficult to get rid of infection. Preventation. Ringworm is difficult to prevent. The fungus that causes it is most common, and the condition it is contagious even before symptoms appear. Take these steps to reduce your ringworm risk of ringworm. Educate yourself and others. Keep clean. Wash your hands often. Keep your skin clean and dry. Keep static areas clean, especially in the schools, child area centers, gyms, and locker rooms. Stay cool and dry. Avoid infection and infected animals. Do not share personal items. Lifestyle and home remedies. For a mild case of ringworm, try this self-care tips. Keep the affected area clean and dry. Apply an over the counter antifungal lotion, cream or ointment such as Lotrimine F as a directed on the packaging. Common questions. My pet has ringworm and I am worried about ringworm in my house. What should I do? Ringworm can easily transfer from animals to humans. You can take the following for people to do. Do wash your hands with soap, running water after playing with the pet. Wear gloves and long sleeves if you must handle animals with ringworm. And always wash your hands after handling the animal. Disinfect areas the pet has spent time in, including surfaces and bedding. Do not handle animals with ringworm if your immune system is weak. For pets, protect your pet's health. If you suspect that your pet has ringworm, make sure it has seen by a veterinarian or so treatment can be started. If one of your pets has ringworm, make sure every pet in your household checked for the ringworm infection. There's a ringworm outbreak in my child's school. What should I do? Contact your local healthcare department for more information. Tell your child not to share items such as clothing, airbrushes, and ads with other people. Take your child to see the pediatrician if he or she develops ringworm symptoms. Check the child's school or daycare to see if they can still attend classes or participate in athletics. Thank you.